The reach cap, I usually throw a chuck line, then just follow the line with the chuck mark, and that's it, simple. Again, this is my reach cap, you see? My guy is blowing down there. He's getting rid of all the trash, and that's it. I'm done, 100% done. I'm just waiting for inspection, for final inspection on Monday. I won't be here. I'm just gonna leave my ladder here, and the inspector should come up on the roof and just sign off. I mean, I should have like no problem. Oh, the other thing, guys, I wanna point you, when you're gonna pass roof final inspection, make sure you buy the caps for those pipes, the 4-inch cap, 3-inch pipe, and 4-inch cap. Otherwise, you're not gonna pass. In the past, I remember that I didn't want to buy them. I didn't think I needed them, and the inspectors know you need the cap, so I have to buy them and come back. It happened to me like once. Then I learned, so I know what I want now. You have to know what the inspector is gonna look at. Okay, he's gonna look at that you have no shiners. They call it shiners, you know, like some exposed nails. They're gonna walk through the whole roof. They're gonna see that you put silicone or mastic around your pipe necks, and then every single exposed nail has to be sealed with silicone. They're gonna look for you if you nail properly your reach cap, your shingles. They're gonna check your nailing. What else they're gonna check? They will check. Also, if you paint your pipes, some cities they do require you to paint your pipes. Some of them they don't. They don't really care. But it looks better if you paint them at least for a little bit, because later, you know, they're gonna get faded with the sun. You see, the reason I don't install turbines. This is the big reason. You see over there. You see that turbine? They put a piece of plastic on the plastic bag on the top because it's not spinning, so when the water comes, you know, it's when it rains, the water goes inside. So, and again, from here I can see everybody's mistake, even though they say they're too fast. I mean, don't hire the roofer that you think is too fast, okay, because he's gonna do like an awful job. Quality and speed, they're not going the same book, okay. If you're too fast, you're not gonna have time to align your lines. It's better for you to hire a guy that's average, you know, not too fast. I can nail very fast, but I'm gonna tell you the truth. If I nail very fast, my lines are not gonna be straight. Some of the nails are not gonna be in the right spot. So that's the problem when you nail too fast, because you don't have time to control the gun. You don't, because we're not robots, we're not machines, we're just human beings, okay? So my suggestion for all the homeowners that are watching this video, all the general contractors, don't hire the guy that's too fast, okay? Don't, because he's gonna do an awful job. Hire the guy that has a minimum, the average speed, and he's, you know, not too fast. Like me, you know, before I used to do about 35, 40 squares a day from 6, 7 a.m. to 6 p.m., one helper. Right now, I'm 38. I'm 39. I can do about 30 squares a day as my maximum, and I can do a basic, you know, good nailing, same speed, same pace. I can nail about 25 squares, but good quality job. 25 squares, and then another guy 25 who can do 50 squares in a day. Two guys, you know. So there's no reason for me to kill me, like I used to do when I started this job, you know, when I quit my company. I wanted to do everything by myself. And anyway, this money you spend, and you spend all the money you make, so you never have money. So I realize that it's not worth it, okay? For all the guys that are listening to me, you know I'm saying the right thing. Okay, even though you make money, you still don't have money because you spend it. The more money you make, the more money you spend. Okay, guys? Have a nice day.